What are ClickUp Reminders? If you're wondering that, you're watching the right video because I'm going to do my best to explain what exactly this feature is, even though it is a bit confusing. So here we are inside the home view inside ClickUp. This is the new home view. If you have the legacy view, it looks something like this. But nonetheless, this is showing us our overview of our day inside ClickUp. And you might notice at the very top of the page here, we have plus tasks and plus reminders. Reminders are basically dumbed down tasks. They are private to you unless you delegate them, and they're just kind of a place to put quick notes. Back when the ClickUp mobile app was pretty terrible, which is not that far in the past, but back when it was a pretty non-functional app, the reminder feature was very useful because it was one of the few things you could create very quickly on the go offline to add notes to self that would then be available inside the ClickUp app. But as ClickUp's app has gotten better, reminders are feeling more and more redundant. So as I go through today, if it's starting to sound like there's not much of a difference that's meaningful, you're getting the message pretty clearly. So let me just show you what these reminders include. Inside the reminders area, you have the actual reminder name, and this is where you can just create the name of the task or the note. So go to the grocery store. Notice I'm using personal life examples because that's one of the best use cases I can think of for reminders. These quick to-dos, these shower thoughts, these quick things that you don't want to forget, you put them in a reminder. Below the reminder, you have a few basic options that are pretty similar to what you're used to for tasks. You can add attachments, you can add a due date, the assignee, which is going to default to you, and whether or not you want to be notified, basically whether or not you want to have it show up with a due date like a task would. And you have notify me, which is basically saying, do you want to send a notification when this due date arrives? Now, by default, when you're creating a reminder, the due date is always going to be today, the assignee is always going to be you, and notify me is always going to be on. And because reminders are something you're going to be creating very quickly, I doubt you're going to take much time to customize these, so they might not be the most helpful. But otherwise, when you create that reminder, you click save. It's a cute little icon of a string wrapped around your finger, and that's basically your indicator that this is a reminder and not a task. Now, once we have a created reminder here, we can go through a few other options. The first is to mark it complete or done. This is basically just saying, I don't need to worry about this anymore. Wipe it out. The next one is to snooze, which is basically saying delay the due date X number of days so that way I can worry about it later. The following one is to convert it to a task. So adding to list will basically turn that reminder into a regular old task, just like everything else. Then we have delegate. Now this is a pretty interesting one, so I'll pop back to this at the end. Next to that, we have delete, which is just deleting the task. And again, an option to notify me or not notify me based on that due date. The delegate one is an interesting button here. This one actually allows me to pick other people in my workspace and put the reminder inside their personal inbox. When I do that, it disappears from my view and shows up under delegated. Now, of course, we could also do the same thing with a task. I could delegate that task by changing the assignee to that other person. If I go under delegated though, those tasks do not show up like a reminder does. So it's kind of bizarre. You can change the assignee of a task and it shows up in their inbox, but it doesn't show up under reminders. But if you create a reminder and you delegate it, you have this kind of delegated view, which allows you to see where your reminders ended up, even if that person ended up creating it into a task. It's kind of a strange feature. It feels a little incomplete, so I imagine some things are going to be changing here. But nonetheless, this delegated tab is unique to reminders. One other very important thing that is unique to the reminder feature, and one of the main reasons that people who are working in multiple workspaces rely heavily on reminders, is because unlike tasks, reminders can navigate between workspaces. So let me just show you this as an example. I could then flip into another workspace, and clearly this is only relevant if you were in multiple workspaces, like a freelancer or consultant might be. But if you go down here, I'm going to flip to another workspace. All right, so now I'm flipping over into a free plan of ClickUp that I have linked to the same account. And as it loads, it loads, it loads, if I go into home, I'm going to see that same exact reminder here. And this is pretty powerful because one of the big frustrations that people who are working in multiple workspaces have is the fact that things are so separate. For example, if you're working with five clients, you have to switch to five different workspaces, and it doesn't take that long, but it's still a pain in the butt, to plan what your day actually includes. Whereas reminders, because they show up in every workspace, they can be a good way to kind of get an overview of all of the things you're committed to, regardless of what organization it's a part of. That can be a pretty nice feature and one of the main values of using reminders over tasks. Now, one more feature that used to be really important about reminders is that you could create them offline. Offline mode of ClickUp previously wasn't quite so powerful, so the ability to create reminders as you went and convert them to tasks when you had an internet connection was really helpful for teams that were working in the field. But now ClickUp's offline mode has improved, and once again, it's kind of made reminders a bit redundant. Now you can create tasks offline and then they'll sync back up when you are online again, and you can actually also do that with reminders. So when it comes to reminders, it might be more helpful to think about what isn't there versus what is, because I already walked through some of the few benefits that reminders have over tasks. They're simpler, you can delegate them, they have that nice little delegated tabs, and they sync across workspaces. But pretty much everything else that a task has, reminders cannot do. For example, if we were to go into a task, we have a lot more options here. We have a comment section, we have a filterable comments and activity log, we have the creation date, time track, start date, due date, priorities, relationships, automations, pretty much everything else that ClickUp does is linked back to tasks. So if I would have been covering reminders about a year ago, I would have had a very different message to share. They were very useful and they still kind of are, especially around the ability to see things in multiple workspaces. But for the vast majority of use cases, for 99% of the people that I talked to or I worked with, reminders just don't really have much benefit these days versus just using tasks. Just like many of the other videos we've been releasing recently, including this one about why I'm leaving ClickUp Docs, ClickUp tasks are just too powerful. They're too good, right? They can do too much too easily that reminders have really lost their edge. Ultimately, if you're asking me whether or not you should be using reminders in your workspace, for the vast majority of people, I'm going to say don't bother. It's not really that helpful of a feature anymore because ClickUp tasks have become so powerful and just easier to use. Rather than relying on these reminders and their kind of dead-end delegation system, just go ahead and create a different space. Tasks are more powerful anyway, and you could create your own private space or just private list in an existing space to keep track of your personal tasks. You might call this personal tasks, or even call it reminders, or call it your inbox. Either way, this is a place for you to put quick thoughts to sort them or triage them later, but by creating them as tasks from the get-go, you make delegating them, keeping data around them, automating them, you make all of that stuff easier because you can do a lot more with tasks than you can with reminders. So in summary, reminders are quick notes to self. They can be turned into tasks or delegated. Tasks, on the other hand, are tasks and you can do a whole lot more with them. If you're unsure which ones you should use, just go with tasks and avoid learning one more feature that isn't really that valuable. But if you guys disagree with me here, I would love to hear in the comments. Maybe I'm missing something about reminders that, you know, is really amazing for certain workflows that I just haven't experienced. That is very possible, and I'd love to have you tell me in the comments below. But otherwise, I think that's pretty much it for this quick overview of reminders versus tasks. If this helped you at all, please do give this video a thumbs up and click subscribe. Until next time, enjoy the process.